Hello everyone, xHedra here, bringing you episode 29 of Forever Stranded, a mod pack by Gaming with Sheridan. So, the lost time lapse is what I needed to complete our setup. Let's take a quick look. First off, I moved the farm here, the enderpearl farm, and made this little spawner. It's a squid spawner, which will also serve as my fish trap bait section. And if I go in, it works on the principle that it has water flowing down, and squids will get pushed here and start dying, and they do die in trove. Completing the quest will not be a problem anymore. Then I fixed a couple of issues with my sieving line and with the fact that this wasn't producing the max power it could, so I added some double layer capacitor everywhere, and I refilled this with lava from the other one. So 3 to 1 lava creation is too much. I'm going to have to rearrange a bit later, but it's not urgent for now. Also, look at this. I finished digging this whole section of the base. All of it. And all that's left is that corner. And I don't know if I showed you this already, but I have the temperature regulator here, so this is never a problem anymore. And I've automated the 2 farm. So let me show you the setup. It's not 100% automated, but it's good enough for now, and I'll explain to you why. I tried making it work with my with this axe, and my idea was to have the crafter use this and this and fix it and push it back. But for whatever reason, Ender.io is unable to push that back. It is able to push regular axe though. So what I did is I put a filter here to send tree tap and stone axe. And if you look into it, there is a stone axe and there is a tree tap. And here I have the crafter that transform oak wood into sticks. And this is set up to output on each side to the other 2 crafter. This crafter has a cobblestone generator pushing cobblestone in it to craft axe that then get pushed out to here. And this one here craft stone hoe that gets pushed down to the farm there. So the only thing missing is the crafter for the tree top. The problem with that is that we're actually talking about 2 crafter. So we might do that today, but I'm not 100% sure. Then we have the saplings coming here, and we need to put a void upgrade, and I had created some axe and hoe before setting that up to get the system jump started. And I put some fertilizer, which I'm not using here because it makes the world lag so much. Trees, so many trees that it's crazy. But I do use it in the farm because I wanted to jumpstart our food production. But now I'm going to take it out and I'm going to stop filling the farm with food, and I'll show you why. Everything gets pushed to this ender chest, and it gets grabbed by my Miami system down there. Like, let me push all of that. See, a seed came in. So everything from the tree, like the apples and the wood fills this first because it's in a shorter way to get to, and once it's full, it pushes the rest there. So, oh, and you can already see a squid dying there. See, the squid is dying because it's pushed out of the water. And then it fills this with 10 more. And sometimes rotten flesh gets grabbed from the mob dying there. So I'm thinking of also closing this down and putting some spike to catch the mob drop there. Anyway, let's go back upstairs and I'll show you one last thing. So I want to go upstairs here. Perfect. So the other thing is I've been creating these, I've been setting up food to create leather because I need leather to get prepared. So let me put the leather in, and now let's look at the bag and let's complete today's quest. And here's my power monitor. So I'm going to need 1 cactus. Do I have 1 cactus somewhere? Let me go grab 1 cactus. And the reason I need the 1 cactus is I need to cook it for the next recipe. So I'm gonna use 1 cactus that I'm gonna cook right here immediately. And while I'm waiting for that, I'm gonna get some steel going. I want more steel. Because what I don't show you guys usually is that in between episode, I go into my other playthrough, one that's, I was going to say is pretty advanced, but it so turns out that we are catching, oh, only one, I misgrabbed the iron, that we're catching up to that world, and pretty soon we're going to be past that world, because I stopped playing it when I decided that I was going to move forward and make a series. Well, I stopped putting as much time and effort into it because I started putting my time and effort into the series. And I only go there to be able to test stuff because I have so much resource from having run it long times doing nothing that it's pretty far advanced. So now, to complete the quest last week, we had to transform this power monitor into a graphical power monitor, and the black wool was topping us. So now we need 5 wool, so we need 20 strings. 20 strings like so. And we need one of each flower, 1, 2. And we need 5 ink sac, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's go back here. Let's color those wool black. Let's transform that into color, this one into color. And we can now craft this and complete our quest. Quest completed. Power usage. I wonder where all the power is going. Some machine will let you see the usage of power. So I want to set that up and show it to you, but I won't do it in this episode because I want to continue moving forward as fast as possible. And now the rewards, at this point, we get so much of everything that none of those rewards really matter. I'll just take the 9 Vibrant Alloy Nugget because they're the most annoying to create of everything that's available. And for the time being, we'll put the power monitor in the quest chest. If we look at the quest, I wanted to do a quick overview with you guys. I've completed almost all of the quest here, and all that's left is a killing task with some skeletons, some spiders, and some creeper. We got the 5 Endermen. And version 1.8.8 has some item placeholder problem. But man oh man do I want this reward, the growth crystal. So even if I complete that quest, I'm not gonna claim it before this gets fixed. In Tankapow, we have these modifiers to create, and the Iron Toolkit modifier, I'm gonna have to get to. I'll search modifier, but I'll show you why it's been waiting. I have to test something in my other world, and I haven't had time to test it. Basically, we need large iron plate, super easy to make, but we need a block of pig iron. And pig iron is the only way that I know of creating it is, let me find it, is in a smeltery. By putting emerald, we have plenty, iron, we have plenty, and blood. So what I'm thinking, and the reason I'm breeding the animals, is I'm thinking that the cows are going to be, I can take the cows and put them in the smeltery, and they'll die creating blood, which is not super nice, but that's the only way I can think of completing this quest. Ooh, so Mr. Sheepy, and I have multiple sheep now, so I might even do it with sheeps also. Was there anything else? Yeah, there was some more to breed. So you just click it until it stops working. And there's something really weird that I wanted to show you guys. Oh, the rabbit's there. It seems that the rabbit are sometime able to escape the pen. I don't know how. I didn't think they could jump over fence, but I thought I already had a baby, and now I was supposed to go up to 3, but one was gone. So I'm not quite sure what's happening there. But so that's how we create the modifier. And I find it sad, because when you look at the next modifier, oh, Ardite, okay. So this modifier, I don't know how to get. I don't know how to get Ardite. Ardite, the only way I know how to get is by, is basically by finding it, I guess. It means in the city. And these plate, they take 8 Ardite each. So we're talking about 8, 16, 32, 38. So I don't even know how to complete the second one. But then when you get to Diamond Toolkit, this is so easy. I've got Prismarine so much that I don't know what to do with it, and a block of diamond is nothing right now. And the Ender Toolkit is Obsidian Large Plate and an Ender Pearl. So I really don't understand how this is balanced. And the reason I want to take the fertilizer out of this is these never grew during my whole time lapse. And the reason for that is I came back upstairs and I saw the particle effect of bone meal. So it was using fertilizer on it. And if you guys know, fertilizer or bone meal actually stopped the growth. That's why they're all at the lowest level. Hopefully now they'll start growing again and get harvested. And if it really does work and we start getting more pearl, I'm probably just going to create another area with another farming station, just dedicated 100% to that. So, now that I've showed you everything about those quests, and I can tell you about the rest. The big steam, it's just crafting. It's pure crafting. I don't know if I have enough resource to do it now, and I'd like to because of the lifeblood crystal, so we'll try it. For these, the MK1s are not a problem, but if we look at them, let's look at the culinary because there's only one thing named culinary, so it's easy to find. The level 2 needs a dragon's breath, and the dragon's breath needs a nether star, and I haven't decided yet how we're going to kill Wither. I haven't even set up a farm to get Wither skull. And if you look at Witherproof glass, obsidian, and dirty glass. So that's probably how we're going to do it because reinforce obsidian. Wow. Okay, this is new. Heavy engineering block and iron sheet metal. So this is super expensive compared to the reinforced glass, which is so inexpensive. And there's these Lonsdaleit, which a member on Discord told me about. I'm going to look up the person name, but I think that the easy solution might be to go into environmental tech and hope that we get some of these. And if I click on it, if I click on how to get it, oh, so it doesn't say. Usually it tells you how you can get it, and it explains to you how, like in which manner you can get it with a black lens or a clear lens or some kind of lens. But at worst case scenario, we're going to be able to do it just with the reinforced glass, a pure reinforced glass place. And then we'd be able to complete that one quest. Then, oh, I didn't read the big steam. So let's read it since I'm going through it. Big steam. Want ever more power? Have loads of machines that make too much? Well, steam is your friend. I haven't tried that. I'm going to test it, try it in my test world to see how much more it gives. So that's it for this side. There's nothing really else to do here. Then in technological revolution, there are the ME things that are missing. But I want to get easier ME crafting, and that's in the upcoming adventure episode. And for here, we could do monsters stop. Well, good offense is a good defense. Let's try and stop these monsters getting to you. Basically, this needs to create an attractor obelisk and an aversion obelisk. And the aversion obelisk needs an Enderman head. So if I have an Enderman head left, I think I should have one or two. I should be able to complete that quest today if I want to. And then there's power of the dragon. The breath of the dragon can be made with Enderman and a shiny star. So this one, I need to complete this quest before I can make the quest in Tinkapow. This one here. So definitely we're gonna have to get to this soon. Then we finally open Moving World, and this is the next area of technology, and we're going to get started on that after our adventures. In creating life, I still have the horse to get, but the horse is 30 wheat and 10 leather, and we have it. And I've been delaying those life quests too long. So let's get that now. How much leather do I have? 12. 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna take those 10 and a stack of this, and let's get our horse. And claim. Stop horsing around. Well, no, you're giving me a horse. I'm gonna horse around. So I got the horse, and oh, maybe that's what happened. See, this one jumped. It was in there, and now it's here. I really don't understand. Ooh, nice horse. I like the double color one. And I'm going to check if I have some meat, because if I have some meat, no, I don't have any meat. I need to start creating more leather for today's plan. So let me come here and sacrifice one or two cows for the greater good. So one, where are you? Oh, it died. Two, where? Three. And four, and where's this one? Wow. This cow is going crazy. Although if someone was trying to kill me, I'd probably go crazy too. Anyway, so we got some leather and some more meat. Let's grab all of this and let's cook all of the meat so that we can put it on the drying rack. Anyway, and the reason is that I'm going to need four of these letters for leather for what I want to do today. Because I still haven't told you guys what I want to do. I'm still getting some of the quest out of the way, and then I'm going to talk about it. So sheep, I'm good. I don't need to do that one again. I got my horse, and those are so easy. There's no reason to keep them just to say, oh, I'm going to do them in another episode. It's 6 iron, 6 diamond, 6 gold. So even though I could parcel it to make many episodes where I get my quest completed, that's not fair. I can do this super easy right now, so I don't see why not. So let's start with the easiest one, the gold armor. Oh no, not the gold armor, the iron armor. For you, your horse, of course. Detect and submit, and claim. So this one's done. And then the gold armor, shiny. Detect and submit, and claim. And finally, bling for your horse. Excessive, maybe? Yes, of course. But I still want it. So that's 4 quests in a row. And the one that we completed from the last time, trip wire hook. Wow, okay, amazing. and I also had another one here that we never did. And let's see, I'm going to open this one and it's going to be crazy amazing. Oh, no, not at all. Okay, so they don't really matter. Let's just put them here. And if we go back to the life quest, like I said, I've been neglecting these for so long that I want to get some done. And I need a rabbit, and a rabbit is 5 golden carrots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and let's craft the 5 golden carrot. And I'm not going to get any more of these because, honestly, expensive much for, I find, not so much value. So let's get the 5 golden carrot, and let's golden carrot, hip hoppy, detect submit, and a spawn rabbit. And I'm not even going to put the spawn rabbit down, I'm just going to put it here. Continuing with the quest, this is a quest day. Pig. 20 rotten flesh, 10 gold nugget. So 20 rotten flesh. And again, this is something we could have done a while ago, and probably it would have been good to help us get the reward. Well, not the rewards, to get leather easier. Oh, what am I doing? I don't need to do this. What I really need to do is cash in the quest. So let's go to the quest. Kevin Bacon. Bacon. 1 spawn pig. And the spawn pig I do want, so I'm going to go put it down immediately. And the moment that this quest clear, I'm going to complete it again to get 2 pig to start breeding them. So that's, how many quests is that now? That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 quests. And the one we completed from the other episode, that's 7 quests. The ocelot needs 8 raw fish. Let's start the water trap like I told you guys about. And for the water trap, I'm going to need a couple. I'm going to need 2 of these. No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to need to create 2 fishing rod. And I'm going to use 1 to fish the first fish that I need. And 1 to put in the crafting of the fish trap. The water trap requires 4 stick, a chest, and a fishing rod. 4 fish, not 4 fish. 4 stick, a chest. So I got a chest here. Let me get some more stick. Like so. And bring it here. And now I can craft it. And the reason I was telling you that I need the extra a fishing rod is that you actually need a fishing rod to get started, because the fish bait, if we look at the recipe for fish bait actually requires actually requires 3 fish of anyway. So I'm going to have to use the fishing rod for the first 3 fish that we want to get. And let me grab some dust and let's go put the bait the trap in here, even though, like I said, we're not going to do the fishing as part of this episode. I think you've seen plenty of people fish in Minecraft, and it's not the most pleasant thing to see. So we'll put it right here, and I tested it in my other world, and when I broke it. You have to be very careful. These things are fragile and break at nothing. I'm going to get out of the water and I'm going to break the dust from here because it breaks much faster when you're not in water. So in my other world, I was testing to see if this would work for the fish trap and for the fish and for the squid. So I was staying here and waiting like this and checking the water trap once in a while, and I would back out. But then at some point, someone asked me something upstairs and I was like this in the water and I actually died. So in my other world, I only have 3 life left. I died 4 times, and one of them was because of how dumb I was. So this series is actually doing better, and I actually have more life in this series than in the other one where I've been doing things slower. Let's say I've been a bit more crazy though. Okay, so now that this is done, I'm going to keep this for a time-lapse if I end up doing one. So all that I wanted to do today is done for the base stuff. Now we're ready to go adventuring. This is what I want to do. And I needed to get the last step ready. To go adventuring, we're going to go explore all around here. And I want to be able to explore as fast as possible. And the only way to explore fast in this mod pack is with the diamond jetpack. I didn't create it before because gold was good enough, but if you look at, this is how fast the gold goes. Okay, it's not slow, but it's not super fast either. Let's craft the other one and you'll see. So first, I need 6 furnace because I'm going to do everything in one shot. Oh, I already have 6 furnace, so let's not do that. So I'm going to need 16 iron. 16 iron. I'm going to need 14 gold. Too bad. I'll put it back after. I'm going to need 14 diamonds. And I'm going to need 4 leather. And I'm going to need 18 redstone, if I remember properly. So, 2 blocks, and then I can start. Let's look at the jetpack. And I'm doing a new one fresh, because when I'm going to go adventuring, there's a good chance I'm going to have my first death. So I want to keep the gold jetpack to be able to retrieve my stuff if I die. So leather strap, oh, I need 2 more redstone, oh, 3, and a quartz. Where did I put my quartz? I'm always searching for my quartz. Yeah, it's in a really bad place. And 3 stone, and 3 sticks from here that I just saw. So I can now craft the comforter. Oh, not these. I can now craft the redstone comforter. And now I can craft the first level jetpack. Oh no, I need to do these. So I'm going to need 6 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oi, not what I wanted to do. Easy to pick up back though. So, jetpack. 1, 2. Let's get the iron, the real one. The iron jetpack. Done. Gold, need 2 gold engine. Oh, I made 3. I'm going to put this in the quest chest, but that sucks. I didn't want to have that many. It's an expensive resource, gold is. It's almost more precious than diamond. Wow, give me my 4th gold. Okay, this is getting hard. Gold jetpack, and now the diamond jetpack. What am I missing? Oh, I used 1 furnace. Too many for the 3rd gold one, so now I need 1 more furnace and 1 more blaze powder. And now I should be able to craft my last diamond thruster. And now I should be able to craft my diamond jetpack. Let me go put this away. And I'm not going to fully recharge it. I'm going to get everything that's in there and that's it. Or how much do I have? I have 11 stack, and so let me get 1 stack of this. Let's break it down and let's put the wood plank in there as much as I can. I'm going to recharge it as much as I can. And while we're waiting for this, let's check if I have more steel in one of my bag, and let's craft my testing has discovered the best possible weapon. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So the best possible weapon is the revolver. I thought that the rail gun was the top thing, but it's nothing compared to the revolver. I find the revolver is much better. So first I need a revolver drum. So I need to craft this, and then the revolver drum is with steel, and I need a barrel, and I need a revolver hammer. Then I need, what else do I need for the revolver? I need two grips and two irons. So the grips are made with, where did I put my treated wood? This is a treated stick, but that's not what I want. I want my treated wood. And it's probably in that chest here or in that crate. Yeah, it's in that crate. So, 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, I need 3 sets. And I need to put these sticks like so around copper. And I took 1 copper, not enough. So, 2 copper. And now I can make, oh, 2 more iron. Now I can make the gun. The revolver, sorry. So this is the revolver. Now I'm going to make a couple of speed loader. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, so 12. I'm going to make 3 speed loader. I think it's enough. It should be enough. And they take a lot of space, which is why I only want to create 3. Let's create the bayonet. So an iron sword, 1, 2 iron, and sticks. I'm already out of stick again. I should craft some more, but it doesn't matter. I just want to get my weapon. And then hopefully it's going to be night and I'm going to be able to show you. Perfect. So this is the bayonet. And I'm going to create this extended magazine. So I need 1 steel, 1. So 5 copper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I can get this iron mechanical part. And then I can get the extender. And there's also this extension that I could make, the amplifier electron tube, which does shock damage, but you can only put 2 upgrade on the revolver. And I already have the 2 upgrades that I want here. Now that you've done this for the revolver, you're going to need cartridge. These are the cartridge. And to make those cartridge, you need to do them in the engineer's workbench and you need a blueprint. So we're going to need empty casing. I already know how to craft them. And we need the engineer blueprint, which is 3 lapis, 3 paper, a copper, and 2. So 2 of these, 3 lapis, 2 copper, sorry, 3 lapis, 1, 2, 3, 3 sheets of paper. Where's my 1, 2, 3? That's going to give me 3 sheets of paper. And if you guys have never created this revolver, I don't think you're going to want to use another weapon again. It's really amazing. And it's the bullet that makes the difference. The explosive bullets and the armor piercing bullets and the normal bullets. And now let's grab 2 stacks of copper. And this is, nope. This is how we make the casing. Yeah. So let me split that in 2 like this. And let me, that's a stack. And I don't know if I can create 2 stacks. I would like to create 2 stacks. And that's another 5. So 2 more copper, and I'll just shift click it in because it's going to be easier. So I have 2 stacks. So I'm going to be able to make 2 stacks of bullets. Now I need the blueprint. That's done. I want to create some. What's the armor piercing again? It's constant. And, okay, so I can't do the armor piercing yet, but I can make the casule, which is lead nugget. I want to make a whole stack of these. So I'm going to need 1 stack of gunpowder and 1 stack of lead nugget. I'm going to grab 2 stacks of gunpowder and I'll show you why in a moment. And then I'm going to need, I need 7, 14, 15, 16. 16 should give me 2 stacks of nuggets, right? Yeah, and more. So I'm not going to need this. Oh, but now what I'm forgetting to do is I need the immersive engineering workbench. So let's create this, and then we need a. I've made this many, many times in other playthroughs, so I know it by heart now. Like this, and let's put this down, and it's a really cool thing. Look at this. It's amazing. And I'm going to put the revolver in, and the bayonet, and the extended magazine, and grab the revolver again. And now look at my revolver. I can hit like this, and it's like a sword, or I can shoot with the right click. And if you look, this is the normal quantity of bullet, and this is the extended magazine. So it's not super big, but in the middle of a battle, this six bullet might make the difference between dying or not dying. Then if I come back here and I put the engineer's blueprint, I can put this in, this in, this in, this in, and it's showing me that I can make 64 casual bullets. And now I want to make high explosive cartridge. So I'm going to put these in, and I'm going to put the gunpowder in. And the high explosive is an empty casing, one gunpowder, and one TNT. So now I need 64 TNT. And if I remember, TNT is just sand and. Yeah, so I'm going to need five stack of gunpowder. So one, two, three, four, five. And I'm going to need four stack of sand. One, two, three, four. And then I'm going to be able to craft my TNT. I'm going to turn around here, and voila, 64 high explosion bullet. And let me take one, two, three, four. I'll just craft the extra two bullets. One, two. And I'll put this in, and I'll just two, four, two, and two more casual bullet. So now when I right click, I'm going to load the gun with one explosive bullet because I don't want to waste, and the rest with these casull. And then here's what I can do. I can choose all of these and click and fill it with bullet and click and fill it with bullet, click and fill it with bullet. And what it does is as you're shooting, if you run out of bullet, the next time you click, it grabs one of these and it speed reload the revolver. So it's a really great thing, and it's oftentimes the difference between dying or not, and it's never running out of power. Like, that's really the big plus from this weapon, because compared to the other weapon where we used to run out of energy, this one runs out of bullet. And it's going to be night in 2 or 3 hours, I think, so we're going to be able to test it then. In the meantime, I still want to use this weapon because this weapon can shoot from afar. And the aluminum rod do 8 heart, I think. And the iron does 10 heart, and steel does 12 heart, and graphite rod costs 16 heart. But I'm nowhere close to having enough resource to do these. What I'm going to do on the railgun, though, and I'm going to search for railgun, is I'm going to craft a precision scope that lets me shoot further and with a zoom. So, one, two. Let's craft the precision scope right here. And I'm going to craft the additional capacitor. And the additional capacitor is important because it's something that gives you more energy. So I think I'm going to have 16 shot now instead of only 8. So I'm going to need two aluminum wire, two steel wire. So aluminum, one, two. And the steel I put away here, one, two. And now I'm going to need the cutter, the shears, and the and the hammer. So I can hammer these two steel and two plate, and these two aluminum and two plate, and then I can shear them into wire. And there are more efficient way to create wire. In my other playthrough, I actually ended up crafting the immersive engineering machine that lets you do wires two per instead of one each. And I just haven't taken the time to do it here because even though this is a bit more expensive, it's still much faster. So I have the 4 HV wire, and now I need these three expensive HV capacitor, which is nine steel ingot. Oh wow, I have barely what I needed. And then three blocks of redstone. So one, two, three. Let's put that back. And then I know that I need three block of lead because I remember the recipe being one for one in the lead to redstone quantity. And what was the other thing that I needed? I also need some aluminum ingot and some treated wood plank. So aluminum, one, two, three, four, five, six, and I'm gonna need six wood plank, and I should be able to craft them now. Perfect. So now I can just click this all in, and voila. And I'm going to add it to the gun. I'm going to remove this and go railgun, precision scope, recharging, and then now the energy store, oh no, it's not 16,000, it goes to 12,000. Well, it's not as good as I was hoping, but it's still not bad. Let's remove the diamond jetpack. Let's put some more plank into it, and let's just recharge the gun. That should go super fast. Gun, perfect. And it's already recharged. Let's put the diamond hammer here and put the diamond jetpack, and let me show you why the diamond jetpack is what we want to use. Look at this. Look how fast it goes. And if I put the over mode, you stay in place. Like the creative ring of flight, the angel ring. You stay in place. So you can whack mobs without falling. And if you start running, like so, and you jet, look. Look how fast I'm going jetpack around. I'm at full speed now. So going around and exploring like this is going to be super fast. But it uses a lot of power, so let me just go back home right now, and let's put it back in the recharge and take the gold one again. We are going to need to make sure that it's fully recharged before we leave on our adventure. So let me take this one again, and now let me go show you the weapon. So now that I have this recharge, this gun, it has two advantages. It now shoots a lot faster, and all the mobs spawn there because of where I went to fly. Look how fast it recharges. And if I hold shift, I zoom in. So it's like a sniper scope. So it makes it super easy to hit the mob, and it recharges faster, so I can shoot much faster. Look at the fire rate. And that's how I'm going to end my quest easily. So when I'm exploring a... Wow, a compressed one. So when I'm exploring a dungeon, I'll just be able to shoot some mobs from afar and complete the other one with my... Oh, it's a good time to show you the gun. So let's go... Oh, this is the gold one. It doesn't matter. So the gun, you right-click to shoot. One bullet, two bullets, three bullets, four, five. And the reason that I'm trying to get them in a pack... Look at this. I'm going to get to my explosive bullet soon. Boom! And when you get the explosive bullets, it's exactly how you think. You do less damage, but you damage all of the mobs. And I'm out of energy for this gun. So this gun still sucks, except when you're from afar. And when we'll go on our adventure, we're going to take a fully charged capacitor so that we can recharge when we need to. So, oh, no, in here. And I'm going to go downstairs and I'm going to recharge the jetpack from a smart place. I'm going to recharge it from this, from the big reactor, because that's much smarter. And see, I still have tons of fuel. And is the auto-eject on? Yes, the auto-eject on. So I don't even have to worry about that. And it's still recharging. So I can keep this on, and I'm going to be able to recharge this to 20 million. So now, last thing I want to do is the backpack upgrade. Because the reason I named this one looting is that's where I'm going to put my looting. And if I die, I don't want to lose my backpack. So let's do some backpack upgrade. So let's go upgrade. And first, let's create an additional upgrade point. Let's create three upgrade cores. So I need three letter, 12 paper, and 12 string. So 12 string, 12 paper, and three leather. So let's transform this into paper. And then let's craft these upgrade core. And not all of them needs upgrade core. But the extra point, and I need the extra point, needs that. So I'm going to create the extra point. So that's four emerald. One, two, three, four. I'm going to grab eight eggs because I already know what I want as an upgrade. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And eight redstone. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And I'm going to be careful here. So I'm going to craft this additional upgrade point. I'm going to craft this eternity upgrade. So that's one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And this is essential because I'm going to keep everything in my pack. And if I end up dying, this upgrade is going to disappear, but that backpack is going to stay in my main bar. Now I need a nesting upgrade, and the nesting upgrade is what lets you put a backpack in a backpack, but it only lets you put lesser backpack, and I have 3 diamond. So what I need is an advanced nesting upgrade. So now if I craft these together and I say one extra point, life, sorry, and I say advanced nesting upgrade. Now if I look in at this has 4 of 3, and now it has advanced nesting, so I can put my diamond backpack in it. And what happened to my, okay, the eternity upgrade. Whew, I really need the eternity upgrade because that's what makes the difference. And the other upgrades I want to make, it's basically for fun. I'm going to create this one here. So I'm going to need some more paper. And when I say for fun, it's just I like these upgrades. They're weird, not super necessary, but they're nice. So I'm going to need 2 buttons like this and 2 buttons like that and some paper. And now I'm going to be able to do the button upgrade. Perfect. And I'm also going to do the damage bar upgrade. And the damage bar upgrade is fun. I have 4 bowls and I need, what is it else that I need? I need 4 bowl. I need 4 string. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's create the damage bar upgrade. And let's add them to this backpack. So when I put the damage bar upgrade, now you can see this is how full it is. It gives you an indicator of how full. Not super useful, but still fun. And I'm going to put the button upgrade, and the button upgrade does this. It lets you push everything into, everything out of, or take 5 at a time or something like that. I'm going to make a second button upgrade just for the looting because I'm going to want to just push everything in the looting bag as fast as possible. So I have one last paper, and the button upgrade is 1, 2, and where is it? 1, 2, and these two. And you know what? I have space for more upgrade. I'm also going to put the other upgrade, the damage bar upgrade, because to be fair, the damage bar upgrade is really fun. It's really nice knowing how full my looting bag is. So this one, and then the button one. So 1, 2, and then 1, 2. Perfect. So button. And now I'm going to get my bag back, the looting bag back, and I'm going to go button on it and damage bar on it, and it should be empty. Yes, it's empty. And I'm going to put everything back in here, like so. And I could also push these things in here. It's not like I need them right now. My gun should be reloaded, recharge, I mean, and this I need to continue. I want to fill this completely because that's what I'm going to bring on the adventures with me. And let me get a stack of that. And what is this? Huh. I guess we picked up some torches somewhere that I didn't know of. Let's put the revolver again away, the railgun away. So now we have our backpack upgrade. We have our precision scope or better gun. We have bullets. We have everything that we need. The last thing that I want to craft is an angel block. And why an angel block? Because when I'm going to go explore, I might have to create a platform if we get a blood moon and create a small platform upstairs. Well, upstairs, I mean in the air to stay safe. So I want to make sure that I'm ready for all possibilities because there is no way that I'm going to die if I don't have to. I really want to try to. I'm going to use this as building block. I really want to try and survive and finish this pack with all of the lives as possible. But there's no guarantee. So an angel block, and I'm going to also craft another bed. And the reason I'm going to craft another bed is that I'm going to keep this one on me on adventure so that if I need to, I can always sleep whenever I want. And I'm going to start using the portable temperature regulator. So I might even have 2 capacitor, or I might look into crafting a f 5 million, not 5 million, the next level capacitor. So guys, now that I have everything built, next episode, episode 30, so I'm just super happy that it's working on episode 30. I'm going to go around my base, and I'm going to go over this whole city and then come back like this all over and try to explore around in a almost like a circle until we discover everything. I've seen some other videos and I've explored a lot in my other maps, so I know what to expect, but basically Sheridan has made no secret that there were four cities, and it makes sense to me that they're on cardinal points, so I'm expecting one around here, one down here, one down here. When I started checking for it, that's what I was expecting. And I'm going to put a little marker like this on everything that we find. On this, on this, on that. And this map here that's discovered, it's that I went to it with the another map with the same name because I had two Y2 playthrough. And when I was starting, and I thought that I could find the other city faster to start with the other city, but unfortunately that didn't work. So we're going to discover everything that there's to discover in this map, and episode 30 is just going to be a ton of looting and a ton of fun. So now I'm going to go in a time lapse, very short one, where I'm just going to make sure that everything's recharged, all of my bullets ready, and everything's ready to leave this place and go explore. So I'll see you in the next episode. Bye now, and thanks for watching. Wow, I did this all in reverse. Let's try that again. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye now!
Zone 9.